The purpose of the church is to glorify God. Now you're getting more men-centered. Let your works so shine before men that they might see your good works and what? Glorify your Father. Now let me tell you what that means. The word glorify is the word doxazo that comes from doxa that means an opinion. It's the simple word in Greek, an opinion. To glorify God means that you have an exalted opinion of that person. And for men to glorify your Father, it means that non-Christians, by watching the quality of your life and the nature of your words and the treatment of your mate and the treatment of your friends, the conducting of your affairs, will come to you like the Queen of Sheba did to Solomon. And she will say, I have heard of you by the hearing of the ear, but I see you. And the half that I heard is not true. She beheld him, his servants, their attire, his stairway into the presence of God in the temple, and she said, essentially, great is God of the Hebrews. She glorified God. Those on the boat with Jonah saw this audio visual of him swallowed by the big fish as an atonement for his disobedience. They saw the God that could take the heavens and the earth and stir them up, that could have a fish swallow him. They realized he is a great, holy God to be obeyed. And immediately those sailors repented, they sacrificed, and they made vows. These are sailors now. And they cleaned their lives up. Do you know why? Because out of even the sinfulness of Jonah, they changed their opinion of their deity, that God is great. Now that's the purpose of the church, is to glorify God. Let me put it like this. Whenever God gave to the nation Israel the unique privilege of being entrusted with the Word of God and the means through which God was approached, of having the understanding of the past, of where creation came from, who they were, and the future of where history was going in prophecy. That marvelous privilege. God didn't take those people and give them land in New Zealand or give them land at the North Pole. He put them in what Ezekiel called the navel of the earth, where you had the Mediterranean and the Western nations here. You had Egypt, Syria, Assyria, Babylon, and then up here you had China, the lands of Russia. God put them where everybody could see them. And it was the purpose of the magnification of His name. He said to Abraham, be a blessing. And both Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob built altars in the presence of the Canaanites and proclaimed the name of God. So the purpose of Israel was not merely to be recipients of God's Word. It was to be a custodian, a vehicle by which all men could glorify Him. Listen to this, just a verse of this psalm. God be gracious to us and bless us and cause His face to shine upon us in order that Thy way may be known on the earth and Thy salvation among all the nations. Now that was the purpose of Israel. God's injury by the nation, Ezekiel put it like this, I scattered them among the nations and they were dispersed throughout their lands. According to their ways and their deeds, I judged them. And when they came to the nations where they went, they profaned my holy name because it was said of them, these are the people of the Lord, yet they have come out of His land. Meaning these are God's people, but they have sinned and been rejected and they profaned my name. But I had concern for my holy name, which the house of Israel had profaned among the nations where they went. Therefore say to the house of Israel, thus says the Lord, it is not for your sake, O house of Israel, that I am about to act, but for my holy name, which you have profaned among the nations. And he talks about he'll regather the nation, regather Israel someday, which he did under Ezra and Zerubbabel and Nehemiah because of God's name. You and I are entrusted with the name of God. This is why, incidentally, you do not trust Christ until you trust a Christian. Do you know that? Every one of you here that calls himself a Christian has put his trust in the God of the revelation of the Bible. And the reason that you did it is because you trusted a Christian. Some Christian somewhere in some way raised your opinion and God used his life to stimulate your thought. And he glorified the God of the Bible. And that's our job.